Hello, my dear subscribers and channel viewers. This story began in 1973, when Robert Emenager and Alan Sandler, well-known Los Angeles businessmen and producers, were invited to Norton Air Force Base in California to discuss the production of a documentary based on prospective research project. The invitees, along with the Commander-in-Chief of the Special Investigation Division and the head of the Intelligence Department, Paul Shuttle, discussed many projects. One of them concerned a UFO. This material was the most interesting. It was immediately approved for development, and it was planned to shoot a film based on it. Emenager and Sandler were informed that there were some documentaries filmed at Holloman Air Force Base, New Mexico, in 1971. In October 1988, one of the state TV channels, Shuttle, gave an interview in which he told that he had seen the aforementioned film. Shot on 16mm film, it showed how three flying objects in the shape of a disc arrived, one of which landed and the other two flew away. On the landed UFO, a door opened, from which three creatures appeared, the witness said. They were as tall as a man. His complexion was strange, probably gray, and his nose was clearly defined. The aliens were clad in tight coveralls, wearing headdresses that may also have served a communication function. The aliens had translator devices in their hands. The aliens were met by the commander of the Holloman base and other Air Force officers. A manager was convinced that he would get the recording data to use when working on the documentary. Robert was even taken to Norton and shown the landing pad and hangar when the spacecraft was parked in 1971. He was then escorted to the buildings, where, according to the military, negotiations between the officers and the aliens took place over the next few days. According to witnesses, the UFO landing took place at 6 o'clock in the morning. The aliens were professional doctors. The pupils of their eyes were vertical, like those of cats. Their mouths were like slits, and there were no chins at all. A manager was told that this was the only recorded case in the practice of the Air Force, when the highest officer ranks directly communicated with aliens. A manager and Sandler planned to expand the plot of their upcoming film as something hypothetical that might happen in the future. The military said that they would give the film with the image of the landing to Robert. However, a little later, this agreement was cancelled. A manager was disappointed and went to his friend at Patterson Air Force Base to see Colonel George Weinbrenner in order to find out why the project to produce a documentary about UFOs was frozen. According to Robert, the meeting took place in Weinbrenner's office. The colonel suddenly began to behave inappropriately. He went to the blackboard and deliberately began to complain in a loud voice. Damn! MiG-25. The Soviets have a lot of secrets that we have no idea. We need to find out as much as possible about the MiGs. Moving to the bookshelf and continue the monologue about the jet fighter, he took the book and handed it to a manager. It was a collection, Eileen Hynek's UFO Encounters, with a signature from the author to Weinbrenner. It was like a scene from a Kafka play. Based on the colonel's strange behavior, Robert concluded that the film telling about the UFO landing is real. Due to the fact that their conversation was taped, Weinbrenner could not report it openly. The documentary film UFO Past, Present, Future was released in 1974, however without the participation of the described secret footage. In addition, a paper book was also published with the same title, which describes the incident in the future sections. In the photo section of the image there is an author's drawing of an alien ship in Hollow Man, maybe the artist on the basis of eyewitnesses' descriptions. Robert's subsequent cooperation with the armed force and intelligence would last for many more years. That's all for today. Like and subscribe. Leave your thoughts.